Vivian Chariot, wearing number 8, right in the centre of this lineup. Another resumption, the great rivalry between Ethiopia and Kenya. This is the final of the women's 5,000 metres. So we wait to see what the tactics will be here in the very early stages. Let's just put this into context for you. As Nia, the Japanese athlete, goes to the front. 3 times a world cross country team medalist, and the Japanese athlete's doing exactly what she did in the heat. As Zadaras Naya takes second place, and all the Kenyans and the Ethiopians, 4 Kenyans, 3 Ethiopians, are quite happy just to sit in. Laura Pressman just in behind the Russian. But Dave Moorcroft, this is a fascinating rivalry. Dafar wins the world title in 2007. Chariot gets the silver. 2 years ago, Chariot wins and Dafar ends up with the bronze. But Chariot surely is the form athlete. Is there anything anyone in this field can do to stop her getting the double?
She is the strong favourite. She's the outstanding female distance runner in the world at the moment. As you said, she's the defending her world title. She won the gold at the 10K a few days ago. And she's also the current World Cross Country Championship, which is one of the most prestigious championships in distance running. At the moment, apart from Leah, the Japanese lady who's leading, the rest of the field are running fairly pedestrian pace. For Helen Clitheroe in 4th position with the black socks on, she'll be delighted that it's quite cool today, because when she ran the heat and qualified as a fastest loser, the heat and humidity was vicious.
Zadaras Naya has taken the lead from the Japanese athlete, who's still in second. Fleshman in 3rd. And then 4 Kenyans and 3 Ethiopians, all just waiting and biding their time. The Russian is winding up the pace gradually, but all of the East Africans are operating well inside their comfort zone, Dave Moorcroft.
Which I think is playing into Chariot's hand, and as I sort of said earlier, you hope that at least one of the athletes takes the initiative at some point in the next few laps and really tries to make life difficult for Chariot. Here's Masai, Chariot following her. You know, Masai, a great athlete with a wonderful reputation, but if she wants to get rid of Chariot, she's really got to get her head down. And Dafar in 2nd place, the Ethiopian. At the moment, all the Ethiopians, all the Kenyans are in exactly the right position. And actually, Helen Clitheroe is doing pretty well. She's tucked in at the back of that group. And, you know, she's given her best so far, and she's still with the athletes. And they're coming up to, it will be 6 laps to go next time they get through the finish line. But Masai looks comfortable, but it's nothing like a decisive break.
Inside 600 metres to go. Meseret Dafar on the outside. They're starting to crank it up. Lynette Masai, the taller of the Kenyan, moved to the back of that group there. She got boxed. Can she come back round on the outside to get back into a favourable position? 4 Kenyans, 3 Ethiopians, and they're all waiting and watching to see whether Vivian Chariot is going to go.
You know, Chariot, the bell now, 1 lap to go. Chariot's made a move. She's winding it up. She's looking over her shoulder. There's no turning back. My guess is she won't accelerate quickly. She'll just gradually wind it up down the back straight. But Dafar is in the perfect position.
Here we go then, 300 metres to go. Meseret Dafar pushing, trying to get onside. Ijegu is in there as well. So Vivian Chariot from Meseret Dafar, the 2 champions. Kibet is still in there as well. Vivian Chariot looks over her shoulder. Meseret Dafar is still there. She's going to have to really earn it if she's going to do the double. Vivian Chariot coming away now. She's got 80 metres to go. She's accelerating. And is Meseret Dafar going to hold on to silver? No, it's going to be another Kenyan victory. Vivian Chariot does the double. Kibet gets the silver. And Meseret Dafar once again has to settle for bronze. Vivian Chariot was magnificent in that race. She waited, and when she went, it was decisive. That was absolutely superb, and Meseret Defar arguably got what she deserved. She didn't try and take the race by the scruff of the neck. She had to settle for the bronze. A magnificent double for Vivian Cheruiyot.
You know, that was the perfect distance race. Cheruiyot probably got to the front a little bit earlier than she wanted to. Look at her, she's really pleased. And she's done the double, the first athlete to do the double at this World Championships. There's Defar. She dropped out of the 10. I guess she should be pleased that she's got a medal. But for Cheruiyot to wind it up the way she did, you know, it really is impressive, because gradually she turned the screw over the last 500 metres. And coming off the top end, she found one more kick, the kick that was decisive, and there's Helen Clitheroe. And Helen ran a great race there. She did well to qualify for the final. We'll get her time in a minute. But I'm really pleased for Helen. She's made the final, and she's done herself proud.
Well, Vivian Cheruiyot looked over her shoulder. She knew Meseret Defar was there, but she is the world cross-country champion. She won the 10,000 metres a week ago, and she just came into this race so, so full of confidence, Dave. In her mind, this was never in doubt.
She controlled the whole way through. She dominated it. She asserted her authority, even though she was tucked in the inside for many laps, running anonymously. But then when she got near the front, and particularly when she took the lead, she didn't panic. She didn't go too hard too early. And now she's the double world champion, the first athlete to do the double at this championships. And my, did she deserve it.
It was an absolutely outstanding performance. And there, the moment of congratulation, the moment of triumph, and this brilliant Kenyan distance running success story goes on. And look at the anguish on the face of Defar. There's the result. Gold for Kenya, Vivian Cheruiyot. Silver for Sylvia Kibet. Meseret Defar having to settle for third place on this occasion. And looking down the list of finishers in 12th place. And Helen Clitheroe doing terrifically well to reach the final. 15 minutes 21.22. She finishes 12th.